Good afternoon and welcome to our poster, Cadmus, a pipeline for biomedical full text retrieval. My name is Antoine Lin. I am a PhD student at the University of Edinburgh. And today I am presenting you the work I have been doing with Jamie Campbell, David Fitzpatrick, and Diane Simpson. What's Cadmus? Cadmus is an open source system developed in Python. The aim of Cadmus is to generate agnostic biomedical full text corpora. The system is composed of three main steps. The first one, query and metadata collection. The second one, document retrieval. And finally, the third one, document parsing and collection into a single file. Let's move on to metadata collection. During metadata collection, we are using BioPython, NCBI, and Crossref API and services to collect key information for the user and for Cadmus. We are especially looking for three record identifiers: the PubMed identifier, also known as PMID, the PubMed central identifier, PMCID, and the digital object identifier, DOI. On top of that, we are collecting the title, the abstract, the authors, the journal, the publication type and date, and the licenses. Once the process is completed, Cadmus is moving on to the next stage, document retrieval. For document retrieval, we identify a few services and API who can help us find the publication. We are using Europe PMC, PMC, DOI, Crossref, and PubMed. We have an avenue of options to choose from, and we decided to first use the link previously collecting using the Crossref API during the metadata collection. These links are for data mining usage, which makes them the perfect candidate to start from. After that, we are using established repository of open access publication, like Europe PMC or PMC. Then we try to get the publication using the publisher API if it exists. Finally, we are scraping the publisher webpage to find the publication. During that process, we are expecting four different format types: PDF, XML, HTML, and text file. In order to parse the content out of this file, we are using the Beautiful Soup library for HTML and XML, the Tika library for PDF, and for text file, we simply load it into Python. Once the file is loaded, we clean it and remove any artifact to make it text mining friendly. When handling an HTML format, we also try to identify candidate links that we can use later in case we have not found the publication before. Also, once the document is retrieved, processed, and parsed, we save it to a predefined directories to allow you to take a look at the document later. What are the capabilities of Cadmus? Well, Cadmus is able to retrieve open access and non-open access publications where the user has the right to retrieve them. Cadmus processes and extracts content from the four format types I listed before. Cadmus is dynamic, which means it is able to handle updates without requesting the previously collected document. You can update a search by either adding new search term or simply by running the code every week to get newer publication. Cadmus stores any document retrieved to a predefined folder, and Cadmus is robust to server error and power failure thanks to a saving process. And Cadmus is robust to IP blocking since we are using the polite way for requesting publication. How to evaluate Cadmus? In order to evaluate the performance of Cadmus, we used four genes: FMR1, MECP2, FGFR3, and PSEN1 with the query gene name and human mesh and English language. We then compare both using Olir bit against 2010-2020 and subscription against open access. For the whole year, the retrieval rate is around 85%. When, for the 10 last year, between 2010 and 2020, the retrieval rate is around 89%. When looking at the open access, the retrieval rate is about 59%. In conclusion, CADMUS is a tool for the automation of full-text article retrieval. The system retrieves and stores multiple format types for each article, and the retrieval rate is influenced by the subscription and has a tendency for a higher rate for newer publications. It is important to note that published literature is subject to copyright, so one needs to be mindful about the redistribution and how he wants to present one's work. CADMUS has been developed within the UK research environment, which legislates for the right to data mining and text retrieval for research purposes. If you want to give us feedback, if you have any questions, or if you want to take part of the adventure of developing CADMUS, feel free to send an email to any of the email addresses on top of the poster or by passing by our Git page, www.github.com/biomedicalinformaticsgroup/CADMUS. See you soon on the chat.